Samsung's hot new Galaxy Z Flip costs almost $1,400, comes with an amazing glass folding screen, and brushes? That's right, brushes. Little fibers lining the hinge that Samsung says help prevent dust particles from getting inside and damaging the display. If you actually buy a Z Flip and turn it on, Samsung warns you that the phone is not dust resistant and that you should keep it away from small particles. We're getting some mixed signals here, but it kind of seems like dust could be this phone's kryptonite. So we got ourselves some kryptonite, that is, purple powder. This powder will allow us to see exactly how not dustproof the Z Flip is and hopefully give us some insight on how the debris clearing fibers work. And if any of this stuff gets past those brushes, we should be able to spot it easily during our teardown. After the dust bath, our phone is a bit reluctant to open and close. If you listen closely, you can hear it scream in protest. That could be a problem. Let's get started and find out what happened. An iOpener heats up the glass panels on the back of the phone, and after some careful prying, we wiggle them free. And right off the bat, we're finding flecks of purple dust dotting the interior. Phillips screws hold a few brackets in place, the wireless charging coil lifts out, and we're starting to see how this device is laid out. If you saw our teardown last week of the new Moto Razr, you'll note that the Z Flip is thankfully a little simpler to tease apart. Next, we finagle a few cables and remove a single screw in order to extract the motherboard. All the dust we're finding confirms this phone is in no way sealed up, but Samsung has done something nice here. This rainbow sheen you see on the motherboard is a hydrophobic nano coating. That's right, it's been liquid proofed. This won't save your phone should it take a swim, but it does add a bit of water resistance to that expensive board which contains all your data. With the motherboard out of the way, we can fish out the first battery, rated at a mere 3.59 watt hours. But like the Motorola Razr, this foldable phone has two batteries, so this little guy is only a portion of the Z Flip's full capacity. Before we get to the other battery, we remove the speaker and a smaller board that's home to the USB-C port. Down here, we also find the biggest pile of dust we've seen so far. Unsurprisingly, the unsealed speaker grill is a big weak point for unwanted material ingress. After fighting through the larger battery's adhesive with some isopropyl alcohol, we pull out the 2300 mAh power pack. The two batteries together total 12.74 watt-hours. That's a nice bump up from the Razr, but significantly less powerful than the two cells in the Fold. Just like the Galaxy Fold, the Z Flip has a bezel that needs to be removed before the display comes off, and then a little heat helps us to get an opening pick under that flexible display. The ultra-thin glass display is backed by a metal plate and covered with a plastic layer that scratches extremely easily. Samsung does say you can use a screen protector, but they insist that you have it professionally applied. We've come to the last steps of our Z Flip disassembly and also found our biggest collection of dust, the hinge. This hinge is almost completely coated in our purple dust. This certainly would explain the terrible sounds the hinge was making earlier, but it also makes us wonder just how durable and prone to collecting dust the hinge actually is. On the underside of the case, we find the debris clearing fibers, which allegedly help prevent particles from entering the phone around the hinge. Interestingly, some of them look pretty clean, quite a surprise given the amount of dust we saw on our way here. Obviously, our test went above and beyond normal use conditions, but it looks like these fibers may not work as well as Samsung hopes they do. We are still hard at work finishing up our analysis on the Galaxy Z Flip, and we'll put a link to the full teardown with the repairability score in the description below. This teardown was considerably less complex than the Razr, but basic repairs are still going to be tedious. Based on what you've seen here, what repairability score would you give it? Let us know in the comments and click the link down below later tonight to find out if we agree.